So today we are going to understand what is our complete framework with a simple example. We have seen pieces of our framework, what is the need of the algorithm analysis, and how do you do algorithm analysis now, what is the notation we are going to use it up, and all these phases, some of the phases of what you call our framework, we really understood. But we take a concrete example to go through the complete walk through our framework here to get the feel of what do you mean by the problem solving in reality. So as usual, we start with one of the problems here. Let me do the problem statement here. So given an array consisting of n integers, so in which each element is between 1 to n minus 1, find an efficient algorithm that returns any duplicate integer exist in the array. Let's understand the meaning of the problem statement. I just go read the problem one more time. Given an array consisting of n integers, in which each element is between 1 to n minus 1, find an efficient algorithm that returns any duplicate integer exist in the array. Let's take some input to really get the meaning of the problem here. Let me give some input here. Let's say n equal to 5. So our range will be definitely element range 1 to 5 minus 1, 1 to 4. Let's take a simple example. Your 5 element array. So first element could be 4, next element could be 2, next element could be 3, next element could be 1. Now that's only possibilities. One of them must repeat. Here let's say 2 might be there. The expected answer here is output is 2. So in this case, it's only one duplicate. Let's take one more example. This time, I take n equal to 6. A range is 1 to 5. Let me pick 6 elements. 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, there is a 5. There is a 4. Let's say 2. Again 5. Again 3 here. 2. 3 plus 3, 6. So you can see in this array here, we're satisfying our requirement. Each element is between 1 to n minus 1 range. 1 to 5, each element is 1 to 5, but repetition you can see, 4 is repeated, 2 is repeated, all I'm asking here is any one duplicate. In this case, you can return output either 2 you can return up or you can return up 5, any of them is fine. So that's what the problem is asking us to solve. So here, the element range is 1 to n minus 1. You got to find up an efficient algorithm that returns any duplicate integer. So if you have multiple duplicates more than 2, any one of them is fine. So how do we really attack this problem? So if you recall our framework, so always we start with the problem. So then get deeper into the problem, understand the problem. Then in the second phase, we got to think of solutions now. So by looking at this problem, what is that first working thought which we get into our mind here? Let's bring up the patterns in our memory here, whatever you have it up, to get a working solution here. If nothing is there, let's start look at the problem, understand the problem more deeper, at least one working solution, always you can bring it up. The way I'm returning up 2 or in this case 2 or 5, so surely our mind is doing up some kind of a process to really giving up this answer. Let's get out of that idea and see, so how do you really make it as what they call more systematic in nature? Sure. So let me write that as solution number one. Solution number one. So let me rewrite the data to understand how do you really get the answer. Sure. 4, 2, 3, 1, 2. So our n is equal to 5 in this case here. The range is definitely 1 to 4. Now, how do I really got an answer to him? If you just look at this clearly, one simple way of finding up 2 is repeated is, I can start with 4. I'm checking up, 4 is available in the next slot. I'm looking at all the elements which are coming after 4. It's not matching, not matching. So 4 is not repeated, hence not a duplicate. Now I'll take 2. I don't want to look back because this comparison already done. So look forward. So no match, no match. But here we got a match. Once you got a match, return 2 as a duplicate. That means one simplest systematic process, you can build it out. Here is take each element, compare all the elements which are coming after that. If there is a match, we got a repetition and that hence duplicate. If not, continue with the next element. So this is the idea which we can able to give up guaranteed working solution. Let's take much more what they call a bigger size example here. Let's say, so 4, 6 here. Now let me give 7. Next is 8. Maybe my array size I'm giving is n to 9, n equal 9. Range is 1 to 8. Now 3, then is 2. So then I'll give it as 1. Total 3 plus 3, 6, 7. There is one more. So 5 we are going to give it up. So still array, one more element I need to give. One of them must repeat. So let's say 4 is repeat or 5 is repeated. So the problem statement, if you understand carefully, definitely there will be at least one duplicate here. Since size is 9, range is 1 lesser here, one element, one of them must repeat here. So there's no such case where we don't have a duplicate for this specific problem. Now you can see here, if you apply our strategy, take 1. So all the elements which comes after 1, keep comparing, no match, no match, no match, no match. Then take 4, compare here, continue this. Then no match, 6 and 7, 8. Maybe in this case, the last but one element 5, when I compare forward here, we got a match. That's where I'm returning 5 as a duplicate. So this could act like a worst case. So to really understand how good this algorithm is really doing it up, we know from previous sessions that, so we are going for worst case analysis here. Maybe if one would have been immediately available somewhere here, so that would have been a best case for that. But the benchmarking are always, we take what is the right way to really understand complete algorithm performance is its worst case performance. That gives a guaranteed performance, we can say. That's why, so this algorithm, if you want to really get feel of how good it is behaving it up, what input this algorithm really behaves worst way, this guaranteed performance we are able to get it out. So now here in this case, we are really doing up all, only when you come last but one element here, we got an answer here. This is the worst case scenario. Let's try to label this idea and also try to analyze this algorithm to really get a clarity how good is really, is behaving it up. So solution one, since it's like a naive strategy, we really call this as naive or a brute force. But how do you analyze our dimensions now? We saw from previous sessions now, there are two dimensions or matrix we should analyze for every algorithm. So one is time dimension, other is space dimension. They are the two matrix. So for every algorithm, theoretically, we always analyze. Before writing a code, we try to do that to filter out so non-useful solutions, and we pick a few of them after filtering it up before going for actual coding and evaluation. So here, what is the time complexity of this algorithm? What is the space complexity of this algorithm? We want to understand. Again, if we recall, what is the meaning of time complexity? We want to analyze theoretically without dependent on any hardware, operating system, or language. We know that time is always the number of low-level operations. Here in this logic, what is that low-level operation we are doing up? If you look at, so first we are taking this element, we are comparing. Then we take this element, we compare. This guy keep on comparing. The core operation here is a comparison, which is surely a low-level operation for any kind of processor. How many comparisons, maximum, worst case we are going to do it up, is going to be guaranteed performance. That's why our time complexity, which is system independent, what they call analysis, is really giving up. So now we want to really analyze that. That's where we'll try to analyze how many. First guy, I may require almost all n minus 1 comparison in the worst case. Second guy, n minus 2 comparisons. Third guy, n minus 3 comparisons, and so on. Last but one, we need one comparison. This is surely a maximum here. That's where we write it as maximum here. So how do you really, get an expression for this? N minus 1 multiplied by N by 2. So which is nothing but less than or equal to N square minus N by 2. We know from our notation, this is nothing but big of N square. Even more tighter bond, we can write theta. So you refer to other videos we discussed, the symbols now, you get a clarity on why I use theta here. This is the time complexity of the first algorithm. What is the space complexity required for this algorithm here? Again, to recall, space means now we are not interested about how many exact number of bytes, because each hardware, a word size is different. That's why space, when you say it up, how many number of words extra this algorithm require to get this logic, implementable here. So that's where space, if you look at here, first element will take it up. We got to compare, maybe one index variable can help us to move on through the remaining part of the array. So the same thing carries for every element. So few variables, constant number of variables are enough here. We write that as C units now. Let me rewrite here. Space complexity is C units. Again, this we analyze, when you really write into notation, it is big of 1. That's why in summary, our algorithm 1, solution 1, so we'll take time complexity as theta of n square, space as constant here. So is it a good algorithm for production grade systems here? When n is going bigger and bigger here, the scale of this algorithm, how would it is? So theoretically we got n square, but let's experience the coding of this to see what do you call the scale of the n square algorithms here. Let's move on to the coding. So let's understand how to really program this algorithm 1. It's called a naive strategy here. It's which is taking n square algorithms here, space of constant. How well these n square algorithms really perform in practice? So let me create what do you call a new file. Let me just name this as find duplicate here .py. Saving it. Now, so what is our thought process here? Let me just close it off. So thought process is going to be, take this first element, you got to compare with all further elements. So write a prototype. So define find duplicate 1, first solution. So input will take it up a list. So I call it as INP here. Now, so start from the index 0 here. Then we compare all forward elements now. So take a loop for I in. So range function I'm using up, range of. What is the length of the input array? Let me take as N equivalent to len of INP here. Now when I give range of N, means it really gives up 0 to n minus 1. Now I starts from 0 to n minus 1. For each element, what should we do? So take a loop, inner loop, for j in. I should start from next index. So if I'm starting the ith element, immediately from next element onwards, we got to compare. That's where we take a range, starts from next index I plus 1. That's what we are going to give. That is the starting point anyway. From there, we need to go to what now here? End of it anyway here. So I give you what they call start, I'll give you end. That's where I plus 1 to n we are going it out. So what should we do? We compare if so INP of ith element is equivalent to INP of j. Now we got the element, we just written back here. That's where right written of INP of I. But if nowhere this element we got a match, that means so it doesn't happen in this case because we know that at least one duplicate exists in a way. But for return statement, so as a to avoid the issue here, I'm writing a return sys dot. So the special value I'm going to return here, let me import sys min or max value. I'm using up min value here. So as a way to return back here, as a way to return this min value here. So let me save this. So this is what they call it as solution number 1. How we test this is working correctly or not here. Let's write a main method here, def main. So let's write the body here. I'm going to pass size of the size n as input here. N is equivalent to here sys dot argv. Second argument is our size. First argument, of course, is a file name, a program name. Now I need to cast this to integer here. End of this, we got n. Then we got create what do you call size of list of size n here. With the worst case, test case, you have to build it up. We know for this worst case will be last but one element which is repeated is worst case scenario here. So let's create a list of size n. So I'm calling INP equivalent to list of size n. Elements are integers here. So create n size. This creates up the empty list of size n. But how to fill them? Let me write this as test case 1. Fill this INP here. Let me write what is test case 1. Def test case 1. I'm getting up list as an argument here. Let's fill these elements now. For again I in range of 0 to, so 0 is my starting index anyway here. What is my end index anyway here? My end index, except the last element here, every element I'm going to fill it up. Last element I have to repeat the duplicate here. That's where for I in range of, I'm going to give up length. I'm taking n again here. So n is equivalent to len of INP. Now here in the range here, I'm going to give up n minus 1. Starting is 0, end index is going to be n minus 1 here. So this is what range of n minus 1, is enough in this case. Now, what do you do? Let's fill this. INP of I is equivalent to, we write as I plus 1. Because we start from 1 to n minus 1. The last index, I'm going to fill it up. Last index means now n minus 1th index. I'm going to fill it up n minus 1 as a duplicate. So this is how we can able to build up the worst case input for first algorithm here. The program, this is how it look like here. Now let's test this. We got test case 1. After this, INP is filled up. Now let's call a method find duplicate 1 here. Of pass this list here, INP. I'm going to display the result of it. So print here find duplicate 1 of this. Now let's run this program to see is working out or not. Let's go to run here. Go to configuration for file. Give command line arguments now. The size I'm going to pass, let's say 10. 10 elements. Let's run it. Now let me display what do you call. Let me display input also here. Of test case 1, I print INP also to see what is happening here. So go to run, then run configuration for file. 10 elements run. So we got run now. Okay. So the reason why we're not seeing anything is main, we should invoke in Python explicitly. So let's look at explicit call. If underscore underscore name underscore underscore double equal to double underscore main shape double underscore, then you invoke main method. It's not triggered automatically. Now let's go to run configuration for file. 10 elements, run it. Now you can see this is my input here and we got duplicate as 9. Let me try slightly different value here. Configuration for file, instead of 10 elements, let me give 100 elements now. Run it. Now you can see this is my the elements available as part of test case 1 and 99 is a duplicate number. So it's working, but the question is how good it is performing up? What is the scale of this solution 1? So let me benchmark this. Before find duplicate 1, let me import what do you call time package. Let's clock start here. Start time here. So time dot time is what we are really going to get it up. Now after the method is finished up, I take n time is equivalent to time dot. Again, we are really going to have a time. Now we're going to see print the gap here. time taken here, so comma here. So the time is going to be end minus start. By default, it really gives in a seconds animation. So I'm going to display that. So let's run this to see the time measured. Configuration for file 100 run here. Now you can see, so the output is 99 here. This is the time in seconds animation. But let's do what you call performance testing for large values here. Just what they call come in this print statement. We know the solution is working up. Now let's do scale testing here. Go to run. Now configuration for file 100 will make it as 1000, 10,000, lakh. We'll see for 1 lakh how good this algorithm is actually behaving it up. Run. So this is N-square algorithm in theory. Now we are looking at in practice 1 lakh size, how much time this really take it out. Almost 1 lakh square comparisons approximately is required. So still is going on here. So because still red mark is here and we didn't say anything here. So this is a pain. So when really going, n is going slightly bigger, n is really, you know, the N-square algorithms are getting suffered. Imagine in a product. So this is only a small method. When user makes a call or any request comes from any, so from front end side or from any service call, you got to, have a chain of method calls. If one method is this much painful, imagine how much, response time will suffer. This is not an acceptable solution practice now. That's why we want to really think of, is there any better algorithms available than N-square here to solve this problem here. We'll discuss those algorithms now and we'll experience any improvements if possible here. So this is not going to work. Let me kill this here. So let's discuss this, the improvements possible, on top for these N-square algorithms.